Parker.
Back in effect with Poison Pen. Your man was doing it over there.
We came out, we rocked, and there's a lot of overzealous people.
Not excited. Passionate.
And it's fun because I'm having fun too. So as long as there's respect involved,
you
could be as drunk and as happy as possible. It's all good. Like, safe wherever we at, man. So it's fun. It's cool.
I would say last year there was about 15,000 people out here. It was a lot of people. No fights. Everybody's peaceful.
Everybody's chilling. So, and like, I'm glad to be here and have some fun. I'm sorry, man. I'm like,
no, get it done.
Somebody texted me at the same time. But now we're here in the motherfucking Twin Cities, man. I came all the way from Brooklyn, New York, just to do this shit, man. I came out from New York. My DJ Static came from New York. Immortal Technique came out from New York.
Immortal Technique went in. He put your record out last year.
No, he didn't put my record out.
He put a mixtape out.
We presented the record together. That's where the misconceptions.
That's what the perception is.
Yeah. That's my brother all day, and we work together. But my record's not on Viper Records. I'm not his artist.
What up, though?
We're colleagues and we brothers, and I love my brother. I will go to the death of my brother, but
he's
not
a passionate
his artist.
Guy.
Yeah, of course.
But you had a foundation. I remember back in the day, like 98, 99, doing in Boston, doing a lot of Middle East shows.
We was leaving school to come and do shows. That's how young we was.
Breeze Ever Flowing, Poison Pen, C-Ray's Walls, like
long,
unbelievable.
Techniques, DJ Static, Stronghold, and that's what birthed this. You know what I'm saying? We all a part of Stronghold. I'm a part of Stronghold. Immortal Technique's a part of Stronghold. Breeze Ever Flowing, DJ Static, C-Ray's Walls. And that's the reason we're here now. Stronghold was the fucking start and the foundation of all the things we're doing right now.
I remember buying 12-inch singles, records, vinyl, you guys' stuff. How are you keeping up now, being a kid from that era, doing that music now, keeping up in this digital age?
I mean, doing the same thing and maintaining consistency and relevancy. You know what I mean? Like, now people have real short attention spans. So it's like, you can't put a record out in like January and then come back out February the next year. Like, yo, I'm here. People forgot already.
Yeah.
Because it's like the internet made it easy for fast food rap.
Yeah.
You just throw something on the internet, have people download it, and they have the illusion that you're actually doing something. You're actually working. You're actually, you know, making moves within this community. But you know what I mean? It builds illusions. It's all illusions, honestly. But
perception is reality. And if you're consistently on these things and you're working and you're putting stuff out, then you're doing it. You're in the game.
We stay consistently working, and that's the bottom line. And we actually stay on the road all the time because this is where the people are.
Yeah.
That virtual world, this point and click world, I mean, thank you to everybody that supports us in that realm because I'm in that realm also. But a lot of those people that you support on this, you don't see physically. You don't see eye to eye, speak, shake your hand.
Connect with them, bro.
Yeah, like we're out everywhere, whether like, we came from New York just to do this. You know what I mean?
That's dope, though. What you should be doing.
Yeah, every place that hip-hop is, we're there, honestly. Like, we came back from freaking Bogota, Colombia, with no security, running through 80,000 people in the crowd, filming and having fun for hip-hop. You know what I mean?
And you never really, and not to be, no, this is no condescending or anything, you never made a move towards radio. You never made a move like, you always just did you. Like, when I look at Rhymesayers and Atmosphere, they got in their lane, they drove 100 miles an hour.
Right. Same thing. I mean, end of the day, if you want to play my music on the radio, that's good. I mean, you know, use more spins and more BDSs. I'm not anti-radio. I'm anti-force-feeding people the same stuff.
Is that a word? Formulatic?
Yeah, that is a word.
I think so.
I'm anti-that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not anti-playing good music on the radio. Let's be real. Like, I would love you to play my stuff on the radio. I get radio spins. I don't get regular rotation radio spins. It's a difference. It's a difference between what we do and there's a difference between what people are willing to do. You know what I mean?
A lot of people cater.
Exactly. I cater to the people that enjoy what I do. I'm not sitting there trying to impress a bunch of 12-year-olds that just want to watch whatever new thing is on television. You know what I'm saying? That's not what I'm here for. I'm grown.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I'm going to do music and hopefully people gravitate towards it. And so far, so good. That's one of the reasons we sit right here in the Twin Cities speaking right now. You know?
I always been asking everybody, I already know the answer to this question. I started like Biggie or Pac.
Obviously.
Well, you said either or is what you're asking me?
But I think you was big.
I mean, to me, honestly, like, I'm from Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn.
That's what I'm saying. I didn't want to disrespect.
When I was a kid, like, I've actually seen Biggie and spoke to Biggie. You know what I'm saying?
Like, you like the movie?
The movie was for people who weren't totally familiar with the story. You know what I mean? So the movie was good just to keep the prosperity out there. So I'm not mad at the movie. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it wasn't nothing new to me.
Right,
like when Big passed away, when they did the funeral procession, They marched this, the funeral process, they marched this casket past my crib. Like, from that hood.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm going to always get that respect to Big, but I'm going to get that respect to Pac, too, because Pac is a native New Yorker. It is what it is.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Both of them have legacies that are going to transcend anything we do. So I'm not going to pick either or. I listen to a lot of Biggie and I listen to Pac also.
Okay.
It is what it is. I've spoken to Biggie personally. I've never spoken to Pac personally when I was a kid.
Yo, fam, that's unbelievable. I want to, like, he met Biggs.
I'm from Bed-Stuy. There's so many people from my hood, it's not even the same. Like,
DJ CJ can barely hold that camera right now. He's so inspired.
Man, whatever, man.
That's like, your favorite artist, son, from Maple Grove, Minnesota. Favorite artist, Biggie Smalls.
Well, Biggie Smalls, it should be on everybody's favorite list. That don't mean he has to be your number one of all time, but Biggie Smalls is a great, influential brother.
Yeah.
Charismatic, made great music. I mean, yo, respect the Biggie.
Yeah.
What else can I say? You know what I'm saying?
Kobe or LeBron.
See, Kobe's not an old man yet, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be the passing of the torch, but it's not. I don't think Kobe's ready to pass the torch yet.
Yeah.
Because Kobe is still ridiculous with his.
But LeBron is like a beast. He's like a man-child.
LeBron is ridiculous.
I never seen anybody so dominant. When Shaq was in his prime, it was awful on the court. But this kid, LeBron is.
LeBron is a huge problem. But like I said, Kobe's not ready to pass the torch yet. Kobe got a strong five in him still.
Yeah, the Mamba. Come on, Poison Pen. MrPeterParker.com, you already know. Everybody forgets a plug. We got to go back and edit this back. What's up? What do you got a plug?
Yo, I got an album coming out. I mean, come on, man. I mean, I do this music, so I'm going to sit there and promote what I got to come.
Obviously.
My name is Poison Pen. The album's called The Money Shot. Wipe it off your chin.
It's disrespectful, son.
I mean, it's disrespectful, but, you know, I still respect who respect me.
No, I love it.
But, yeah, the album's called The Money Shot. It's Poison Pen. It's M.O.P. It's Immortal Technique. It's Gilly the Kid. Silk the Shocker. Swave Sever.
Yo, I heard about that. I heard Silk's coming back out.
Yeah. I mean, we built... And he wanted to work, and I wanted to work with him. Like, I have a mutual respect because, like, I'm from New York, but all my family's from New Orleans. So
yeah.
We have a real firm grasp in the whole New Orleans thing. And, like, yo, the whole No Limit is pioneers. And oh, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Rest in peace to my cousin Alfredo, who just passed away this week from N.O. Yeah, Mr. Shots to all the wards and everything. And he always told me that I should work with somebody from N.O. And me and Silk been working. So, you know, shouts to Silk. You know what I mean? Shout to all the best out Brooklyn. Shout to the Rebel Army. Shout to Swave Sever, my brother. Shout to Immortal Technique. But the album comes out August 4th, man. It's going to be real fun. A lot of fun, rowdy music.
Stronghold always did it, like aggressive, true school, hard body, fun music.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, my thing is you can convey a message all day. But you gotta have fun when you do it. It's like you rather hear your father preach to you, or you want your older brother tell you what it is. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know? Like if your older brother tells you something, your pops told you, you rather listen to your older brother. He gonna tell you.
No, he's like Chloe. He experienced it. He's on your level.
Exactly. Your pops tell you something, you're like, yo, come on, dad, fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying?
That's love, man.
So yeah, man, love is love. Shouts to the Twin Cities. Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn is here all day. Respect to everybody here at the soundstage, man. And we're having fun, and I'm about to go get a few more drinks.
Word.
I'm gonna call it a day. Shouts to Hip Hop Karaoke. My name is Poison Pen, Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn. Yeah. The Money Shot 1.